So, I thought today I would do something a bit different. I never actually sat down and journaled or talked about my relationship with food. I thought that I would start from my first memories with my relationship with food. Because when I was a baby, I don't remember. I know that I was bottle fed. That's about it. So anyway, this video will be about my history with, you know, because this is a lifelong thing for me. And this is a major part of the reason why this is not going to change for me overnight. So the earliest memory I can remember regarding food, I think I've said this before, but I remember when I was very young, my mother and I were on our own. It was very taboo for her to be pregnant in high school at her age, 16, so she was in a lot of trouble with that. She was a single teenage mom. She was 17 when she had me, and we moved away from the family home, from her mother and father. We were living with them for a while. She wanted to move out on her own and do it on her own, and my father was an alcoholic, so she left him and didn't let him around me for a long time.
These people, like, honestly, if I had kids, I'd be a way better parent than Breezy. Are you kidding me? I would never give my kids away for a bottle of booze. Sorry, I don't care, there's no excuse.
And things were really difficult. I remember we were on welfare, and I remember, you know, treats she would get me here and there. I remember my first bag of chips. I don't remember much else about my childhood. I do remember my first bag of chips. It was a sunny day, and there was a corner store across the street. There was one in the building we lived in as well, but there was one across the street. I think it was a Max Milk convenience store, and we went there together, and I remember just looking up at the sky. I had a bag of dill pickle chips, and it had one of those stick-on tattoos in it, and from then on I was just hooked on dill pickle chips. They're my favorite. I don't know if that was my first bag of chips, actually. I mean, that's my first memory of my first bag of the bag of chips. You know, I was spoiled a lot by my grandparents, and my grandmother on my dad's side would babysit me a lot, and that's all I would look forward to when I would go to see any of my grandparents. My grandmother, she let me just come over and just raid her cupboards. The first thing I would do is go to her cupboards, find snacks, and I think just eating snacks at her place all day long. You know, it would just be, food was just involved in my life every single day. When she would babysit me, you know, I would, I just remember the food she made me. That's all that I remember, and that comforting feeling about going to her house, and she would sit at the stove smoking and making her sweet and sour meatballs. She made chicken nuggets with this, like, Diana sauce. I remember loving that. These Magic Moment vanilla puddings and butterscotch puddings. Oh my gosh, those were good. And she would give me some, and then I would ask for more. So she would give me more, and then I would ask for more. And I remember her at one point, I would ask for more until she yelled at me, and she would say, "C'est assez là," you know, like in French, like, "That's enough. You already had enough snack." Food was just involved in my life every single day. I mean, we do all eat, but it would be on my mind as, you know, anything I do in my life, it would revolve around food. Like, whenever I was younger, even going to theme parks, I was always interested in, you know, you go to, like, on a school trip, we would go to a theme park and an amusement park, and everyone would bring a packed lunch and not think anything about it. They would be thinking more about the rides. I would be thinking more about the food and the cafeteria, and I would just remember really, really longing for lunch money. Most of the time I didn't get it, but when I did get money, you know, I would just be like, yes, I can buy lunch at the canteen, french fries, whatever. I was always interested in the food. Even I remember my stepfather used to try and involve me more. We're building our relationship. He played hockey when I was really young, and he would take me with him. And the only reason I really liked to go, sadly, if I'm honest with myself, was because after the game, he would buy me a hot chocolate in the chuck wagon. If you don't know what a chuck wagon is, it's like a hoagie, and there's, like, different lunch meats and cheese and mustard, and just really good. Well, even at school, the cafeteria food, every day, chicken burger puts in. The chicken burgers were so good. I'd get, like, 3 packs of mayo. I was just an excessive eater and obsessed with food. I just like food. I overeat. It's something I can get a grip on. There's no traumatic event that I can think about. I mean, food was just always there, always comforting me through everything in life. Not just one traumatic event, good events, traumatic events, good events. Even now, as I'm talking to you, I'm thinking about food. I'm terrified of taking that away, because honestly, it feels like there's nothing. There's nothing. That's what my video yesterday, finding happiness without food. What happiness, you know? It's going to take me a while to realize that there's other things. The other things don't appeal to me right now. The only thing that appeals to me is food. I have sleep apnea. I have a, like, pretty bad hormonal imbalance that's causing ovarian cysts. And I can hardly walk anymore. It's affecting my relationships with people. I don't care about... And I know that's such a bad way to think. You know, and... it's just... it's just always been... always been on my mind. It's like a lover. You know, about 28 years of my life or so have been consumed by food. And every memory I can think of, I remember the food first. I don't remember the experience first. I remember the food first. Maybe I will be completely cured, maybe.
This is childproof too, help me.